ओके, अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स. टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस न्यूमेरिकल ऑन अगेन पैरेललोग्राम मेथड. एंड नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व फोर फोर्सेस यूजिंग पैरेललोग्राम मेथड. एंड वी हैव टू फाइंड आउट द रिजल्टेंट फोर्स ऑफ फोर फोर्सेस इन डिफरेंट क्वाड्रेंट्स. सो डिटरमाइन द मैग्नीट्यूड एंड डायरेक्शन of the resultant force Fr. So for example, the question is, the question for four forces is like this. This is F1 equals to 728 newton and the angle is 15 degree, and the other force is 820 newton and that is greater than F2. So the size of the arrow should be greater than F1. So it is 820 newton and the angle is 28 degree. Another force is of 550. So the size will be smaller than as compared to F1 and F2. So F3 will be equals to 550 newton and the angle here is 41 degree, and the angle so the size of this force is more smaller than F1, F2, F3 because it is less in amount. The magnitude F4 is smaller than as compared to F1 and F2 and F3. Okay, done. And the angle is here is 70 degree. So what I have to do, I have to find out FR1 for F1 and F2. First I will draw parallelogram between F1 and F2, then I will get FR1. When I will get FR1, I will solve it with F3 force and I will get FR2. When I will get FR2, then I will solve FR2 with F4 force, then I will get FR3. FR3 is my final resultant and theta R3 is the final angle of FR3. So that will be the answer. So first of all, what I have to do, I have to take in step number 1, I have to take F1 and F2 force. So I'm going to solve this and I am writing here, this one is the step number 1. As we have done in the three forces numerical. So if it is step number 1, so I have to take the force F1 and F2. So I am going to draw the diagram, and the diagram is like this. F1 force is equals to 728 newton, this is 15 degree, and this one is F2 force and it is greater than F1. So it will be F2 equals to 820 newton and the angle is 28 degree. So what I have to do next, I have to make the parallelogram. So I have to draw a parallel line adjacent to F2 and another line parallel to F1. This will be like this. So FR1, I don't know right now where it lies, so I am just drawing an imaginary FR1. As we have discussed earlier in earlier lectures, this one is FR1, so I have to find out FR1. If this one is F2, so this side should be F2 and this is 820 newton. If this one is F1, so this should also be F1 is equals to 728 newton. What I have to do next, I have to find out this angle and I don't know about this angle. So first of all, what I have to write down here, this is origin 0, 0, this side is B, this is A and this is C. So I have to find out this angle. How can I find it out? This angle first. So how can I find it out? I have to find it out by 90 degree minus 28 degree. So I will get what? 90 minus 28, I will get 62 degree. And I have to sum up 62 degree to find out alpha 1, 62 degree plus 15 degree. So I will get 62 plus 15 degree is equals to 77 degree. So alpha 1 is equals to 77 degree. So if this one is 77 degree, so alpha 1 is equals to 77 degree. Now I have to find out angle A and angle C. So how can I find it out? Alpha 1 plus beta 1 is equals to 180 degree. So alpha 1's value is 77 degree. 77 degree plus beta 1 is equals to 180 degree. So therefore beta 1 is equals to 180 degree minus answer, it will be 103 degree. So this will be 103 degree. So this one also be 103 degree. So if it is triangle number 1, so this one is the triangle number 2. So I am going to try take the triangle number 2. So if it is triangle number 2, I will write down taking triangle number 2. If I am going to take triangle number 2, so I have to draw triangle number 2 here. So it will be what? This is FR1 question mark. I don't know. This is triangle number 2. This angle should be theta 1, this angle should be phi 1, and this angle is equals to 103 degree. So if this is F1 728 Newton, so this will be F2 equals to 820 Newton. So this is O, B and C. So what I have to do next, I have to find out by using cosine law, I have to find out FR1. So FR1 is equals to F1 square plus F2 square minus 2F1 F2 cos of angle what? 103 degree. So FR1 comes out to be how much? 728 square plus 820 square minus 2, 728, 820 and cos of 103 degree. So FR1 comes out to be how much? 728 square plus 820 square minus 2 into 728 multiplied by 820 into cos of 103. Under root answer and will be 1212.83 kilonewton. No, it's Newton. So this is FR1. We got FR1. Now what I have to do? I have to find out sine theta 1 and phi 1. So by using sine law, if I am using sine law, so what I have to do? FR1 upon sine of angle 103 degree. And this is what? F1 upon sine theta. Theta. So what I have to do next? I have to find it out. FR1's value is 1212. FR1's value is 1212.83 divided by sine 103 is equals to, the value of F1 is 728 sine theta 1. So I have to do cross multiplication here, and what I have to do, sine theta 1 is equals to 728 multiplied by sine 103 degree divided by 1212.83. So I have to do cross multiplication over here, 728 multiplied by sine 103 divided by 1212.83. So the answer will be 0.58 sine theta 1, 0.5848. So therefore, when we apply sine inverse on the answer, so the angle will be what? 35.79 degree. This is theta. Now what I have to do next, I have to find out sine phi 1. So again, by using sine law, FR1 upon sine 103 degree, and it is equals to F2 upon sine phi 1. So what it will be, 1212.83 divided by sine 103. F2 value is 820 and sine phi 1 is unknown. So I have to do cross multiplication over here, and I am going to do cross multiplication. Sine phi 1 is equals to 820 into sine of 103 degree divided by 1212.83. So what will be the answer? 820 multiplied by sine 103 degree divided by 1212.83. So the value of sine phi 1 is equals to 0.6587. So phi 1 comes out to be what, when I will apply sine inverse on the answer, is 41.2 degree. This is phi 1. Now what I have to do, I have to find out theta r1. How can I find it out? I got theta 1. So if I got theta 1 is equals to, theta 1 is equals to how much? Theta 1 amount is 35.79 degree. So what I have to do next, I have to add 28 degree in it. So when I will add 28 degree in it, so I will get how much amount? 28 degree is this one, because I was taking triangle number 2. So I have to add 28 degree in theta 1. So if I am going to add 35.79 plus 28 degree is equals to how much? 63.79. This comes out to be 63.79 degree. So what I have to do, it is less than 90 degree. If it is less than 90 degree, so what I have to do, I have to find it out, because I am taking this angle from here, 28 degree, and this theta 1. So whether it is less than or greater than FR1 or FR2. So this will be, how can I get it? I will draw the diagram over here. And it is, if it is less than 90 degree, and I am taking this angle from the negative y axis, so FR1 will be here. So FR1 is equals to how much? FR1, what I got it of FR1, FR1's amount is what? FR1 is 1212.83, it's Newton. And the angle is 63.79 degree. So what will be the angle here? So it will be 90 degree minus 63.79 degree. So it will be how much? So 90 degree minus 63.79 degree. So it comes out to be 26.21 degree. So I can write what? FR1 is equals to 1212.83 Newton, and the angle is theta R1 is equals to 26.21 degree. Now what I have to do next, I have to solve F3 with FR1. Okay, now it's step number 2. What we have to do, we have to take FR1. So what I have to take, this is FR1, and FR1 we got in the step number 1, it's 1212.83 Newton, and the angle is theta R1 is equals to 26.21 degree. And what is the value of F3? So F3 is 550 Newton, and the angle is 41 degree. So what I have to do next, I have to draw the parallel line opposite to F and this, like this. So if it is FR1, so this side should be also FR1, 1212.83 Newton, and this one will be F3 equals to 550 Newton. So this is origin, and we have to draw imaginary FR2. We don't know exactly where it lies right now, so I am drawing an imaginary FR2 right now here. And this is B, this side is for example A, and this is C. So what I have to do next, I have to find out this angle. So how can I find out this angle? I know that two quadrants is equals to 180 degree. So if it is 180 degree, so what I have to do next is 41 degree plus 26.21 degree is equals to, so 180 degree minus 41 plus 26.21 degree. So it will be what? 112.79 degree. So I can write here 112.79 degree. So this angle should also be 112.79 degree. So this is alpha 2. So what I have to do next, alpha 2 plus beta 2 is equals to 180 degree. So I will put 112.79 degree here, and beta 2 180 degree. Okay, beta 2 is equals to how much? So I will subtract 112.79 degree from 180 degree, so I will get 67.21 degree. So this will be beta 2. So I will write down beta 2 here, and this is 67.21 degree, and this one is also 67.21 degree. So what I have to do next, I have to take, if this triangle number 1 and this one is the triangle number 2, so I am going to take triangle number 1. For example, if I am taking triangle number 1, so it will be like this. So this is FR2, which is unknown. This should be theta 2, this will be phi 2, and this angle is 67.21 degree, and this is FR1 is equals to 1212.83 Newton, and this side is F3 is 550 Newton. This is C, this is origin O, and this one is B. So by applying or by using cosine law, what I have to do next, FR2 is equals to FR1 square plus F3 square minus 2FR1 F3 cos of angle how much? 67.21 degree. So it will be like this. So FR2 is equals to 1212.83 square plus F3 is 550 square minus 2 1212.83 into 550 into cos of angle, how much? 67.21 degree. So it will be, what I have to do next, 1212.83 square plus 550 square minus 2 into 1212.83 into 550 into cos of 67.21, and I am taking under root of the answer. So it is, therefore FR2 is equals to 1121.018. It's in Newton. So this comes out to be like this. So what I have to do next, I have to find out theta 2 and phi here. So how can I find it out? By using sine law. So for sine law, what I have to do next, you can see here that the opposite angle of FR2 is 67.2. 1 and FR1's opposite angle is Φ2 and F3 opposite angle is θ2. So what I have to do next, I have to find it out. So what I have to write it down, FR2 upon sine of angle 67.21 degree is equals to, if I am going to find out θ2, I will write down F3 and sine θ2. So FR2 value is, which we find out, is this sine 67.21 degree is equals to, the value of F3 is 550 and sine theta 2, so sine theta 2 is unknown, we will do cross multiplication, and sine theta 2 is equals to 550 multiplied by sine 67.21 divided by 1121.018. So we have to do cross multiplication, 550 into sine of 67.21 divided by 1121.018. So it comes out to be sine theta 2 equals to 0.4523. So when I will apply sine inverse on the answer, is theta 2 is equals to, comes out to be 26.89 degrees. This is theta 2. Now, by using sine law again, using sine law. So what I have to find out? I have to find out sine phi 2. So FR2 upon sine 67.21 degree is equals to FR1 upon sine phi 2. So what I have to do, I will write the value of FR2, 0.1018 divided by sine 67.21 is equals to FR1's value is 1212.83 divided by sine phi 2, and phi 2 is unknown. So I will do cross multiplication over here. So when I am going to cross multiplication, I will find out sine phi 2. 1212.83 multiplied by sine 67.21 divided by 1121.018. So I will do cross multiplication here. 1212.83 into sine 67.21 divided by 1121.018. So it will be 0.9974. So sine phi 2 is equals to 0.9974. So I will apply sine inverse over here on the answer, and the angle will be phi 2 is equals to 85.89 degree. This will be the phi 2. Okay, what I have to do next, I got theta 2. So the diagram is here. If I got theta 2 here, so I will add theta r1 in it. Theta 2 plus theta r1 So it will be theta 2's value is 26.89 degree plus the value of theta r1 26.21 degree. So I will add both the values and what I will get 26.89 plus 26.21, it will be 53.1 degree. 3.11 degree. So what I have to do next, I have to draw the final resultant diagram of FR2. So FR2, the value of FR2 comes out to be what? 1.018 newton. So it is in newton and the angle is theta r2. Theta r2 is equals to 53.11 degree. Now it is step number 3 where I have to solve FR4 with FR2. So what I have to do in the step number 4, step number 3, I have to solve this force FR2 is equals to 1121.018 newton and the theta R2 is equals to 53.11 degree and FR force is 434 newton and the angle is 70 degree. So it is in the three quadrants. So what I have to do, I have to draw the parallel line FR2 and I have to draw parallel line to, this will be like this, this will be like this. So what I have to do, I have to draw, this is FR3 which is unknown. What I have to do next, I have to find out this angle. For this, this is O, this one is B, this one is A and this one is C. So what I have to do next, I have to find out this angle. How can I find it out? I know that when I have three quadrants, so it should be 270 degree minus how much? 70 degree plus theta r2 which is 53.11 degree. So 270 degree minus 70 plus 53.11 degree is equals to, comes out to be, the value is 146.89 degree. So it comes out to be 146.89 degree. So it will also be 146.89 degree. I have to find out this angle as well. So what I have to do next, I have to write it down. And one more thing I have to mention you here is F4 is equals to 434. This is a parallel side of OA and this side will be FR2 and which is equals to 1121.018 newton. So what I have to do next here is alpha 3 plus beta 3 equals to 180 degree and alpha 3 comes out to be 146.89 degree plus beta 3 equals to 180 degree. So I am moving towards, I will tell you this, this is triangle number 1, this is triangle number 2. So beta 3 value comes out to be what? 180 degree minus 146.89 degree. So it comes out to be 33.11 degree. So what I have to write here, 33.11 degree. And this one is also 33.11 degree. So I am taking triangle number 1. So if I am taking triangle number 1, so this will be like this, this is FR3, which is the question mark. O, this side is B, this side is C, this is FR2. FR2 is value is 112.1.018 newton. This side is F4 equals to 434 newton. And this angle is unknown, and this is, for example, theta 3, and this is phi 3, and this angle is how much? It is 33.11 degree. So what I have to do next, by using cosine law, what you have to do, FR3 is equals to FR2 square plus F4 square minus 2FR2 F4 cos of angle is what? 33.11 degree. The angle opposite to this, like this. Now FR3 is equals to FR2 112.1.018 square 434 square minus 2 112.1.018 square 434 square and cos of 33.11 degree. So I have to solve this. 112.1.018 square plus 434 square minus 2 into 112.1.018 multiplied by 434 multiplied by cos of 33.11. So under root, the answer is FR3 comes out to be 793.7211 newton. We got the value of FR3. Now what we have to do, we have to find out theta 3 by using sine law. What I have to do, FR3 upon sine of 33.11 degree is equals to that theta 3 is opposite to F4, so F4 upon sine theta 3. So FR3 value comes out to be 793.7211 upon sine 33.11 is equals to the value of F4 is 434 newton divided by sine theta 3. So we have to do cross multiplication over here. Sine theta 3 is equals to 434 multiplied by sine 33.11 divided by 793.7211. So the value of theta 3 comes out to be what? 434 multiplied by sine 33.11 divided by 793.7211. So it comes out to be sine theta 3 0.2986. Now I have to apply sine inverse on the answer, so I will get the value of theta 3, that is 17.37 degree. Now what I have to do next, I have to find out phi 3 by using sine law. FR3 sine phi 3 FR3 793.7211 divided by sine 33.11 is equals to the value of FR2 is what? 112.1.018 sine phi 3. So we will do again cross multiplication over here, and we will write down sine phi 3 is equals to 1121.018 multiplied by sine 33.11 divided by 793.7211. So I will do cross multiplication over here. 1121.018 multiplied by sine 33.11 divided by 793.7211. So sine phi 3 is 0.77149. So we will apply sine inverse on the answer is, so phi 3 is equals to 50.48 degree. So now we got theta 3, and theta 3 value is, theta 3 is equals to 17.37 degree, and we have to decide theta r 3. How can we decide theta r 3? So what we have to do, we have to add theta 3 plus theta r 2 is equals to 17.37 plus how much theta r 2 is 53.11 degree. So I will get 17.37 plus 53.11 degree is equals to 70.48 degree. So it is what theta r 3. So the final resultant will be like this. So final resultant value is what? FR3 is equals to how much? 793.80 newton, and the angle theta r3 is equals to 70.48 degree, and this will be the final resultant of the three or four forces. This is the four forces question. We have done four forces here, and the answer we got it right now is this. This is the final resultant answer. These were four forces, and the final resultant magnitude and direction of the resultant force is this. FR3 is 793.80 newton. Theta r3 is equals to 70.48 degree. So this will be our answer for four forces, and it is very easy. If you will do, you will find it very easy, because it is not difficult after doing two or three forces. So I hopefully you will understand and you will do it. Thank you so much.